Hi, and welcome to this quick walkthrough with Synchron pianos and the first piano in the Synchron series, the Yamaha CFX. A great piano with a new interface that is based on the Synchron engine, the Synchron player engine that's coming up soon. So you have a few things that are new in here. First of all, it looks great. Of course, it sounds great as well. So you have a play view, you have a mix view that holds all the different microphones we've recorded, and an edit view that lets you fine-tune the dynamics and the volume of all the keys. Let's start with the play view, with the most essential controls, with reverb, volume, and dynamic range to the left, and body and sympathetic resonance, MIDI sensitivity, and half-pedaling pedal noises to the right, and some tuning things here, and you have three pedals down here, soft, sostenuto, and sustain pedal. Let's listen to the sound real quick. This is the concert room mix. You see that up here. And of course, recording at Synchron Stage Vienna, we're very proud of this room and we've captured the beauty of this hall. Sounds like this. In the higher regions, you can hear it already. A big part of what makes this piano sound so good are the release samples. For each microphone, you have up to 30 different release samples, depending on how long you hold a note. You will always get a different release sample on all the different microphone channels that you have open. So that's up to 300 release samples for every note there. Anyway, so you can tune these sounds, and of course we've added a little bit of algorithmic reverb on top of it, as you would do in any recording situation. Let's just lower the reverb here so you see what's actually in there. With the additional reverb, sounds like this, and of course you can adjust the amount of reverb there. Okay, so that's the concert room mix preset that we're starting with. If you want to get in a lot closer, volume is of course clear. The dynamic range control, I'm just putting that all the way down. If I do that, that's like MIDI compression. So even my low notes will come out very loud. So the piano is becoming louder. So that's a very nice option to find the right feel for the piano, especially in combination with MIDI sensitivity. If you take the MIDI sensitivity all the way up, every note will be a forte that you play. If you take it all the way down, everything will be piano, no matter how hard you hit the keys. So you find something in between. We think that the setting here at zero is pretty good. You decide how you want to have that. What I like for adjusting that, also to find out how your keyboard works, is the velocity histogram you might know already from the Vienna Imperial. Up here you just see what kind of MIDI input you get. So you can tune your piano and adjust it to how the interface works. The volume display, you have a second volume knob up here, so you can access the volume from every single view in here. You can adjust the screen size of it, rescale the whole system, and just say just adjust it to what you have available in your screen of real estate. There is a real-time CPU meter that shows you what's going on in the background. So you always know what's going on. The settings here with interface settings, the engine settings, this one is especially important. You can unload samples with mixer channels. Now I have all the samples loaded so I can switch quickly between the different presets. But if you unload the channel samples with the mixer channels, you stay more economic with your RAM needs. What else is important here? In the interface, you can activate the continuous sustain pedal. We'll get to that in a second. And of course, the database settings that take care of your presets and your volume scan paths for the sample content. So that's in the settings. And there's not just the room mixes. In the upper right corner, you always see which preset you have loaded. There are the room mixes, but there are more than just the room mixes. And let's get to the mix page really quick and do that with another preset. So this is the config preset. The total opposite is the intimate preset. So loading that will be a little bit smaller. You're sitting like inside the piano with a little bit of a taste of the room that's in the background. Let's see what's happening here in the mix. Every room mix preset comes with a room mix channel, and that room mix channel consists of a ready-made mix of all the microphones, all the room microphones that you get with the full library. It is included in the standard library, so you benefit from a great resource-friendly approach, having a whole room mix here taking care of the room impression, and the close microphone in this case would take care of the close microphone. Let's just mute the room mix for a second. And also deactivate the reverb here. So you have a reverb sent for each channel, and you can, that sends it to the reverb, the algorithmic reverb settings in here. I'm just gonna deactivate that, and we're just listening to the closed microphone. You also hear that the sound is a little bit muffled because we basically took the high frequencies out. You can easily adjust that. You can switch off the different notes. Nodes here in the EQ window, or you can switch off the EQ all in all. Get a different impression here and bring in the room sound. Again, let's switch off the EQ. If you switch it back on, you just see what we're trying to do there, just giving you a little bit more. This muffled sound. Whatever you do in the mixer, you cannot really go wrong. All of these microphone channels, you have the room mix, close mic, the first one, the second one, two mid microphones, one, and the first one comes with the standard library, the second ones come with the full library. You have the Decatree main and main center, and you have additional room microphones, the surround microphones, the high stereo microphones, and the high surround microphones. And you can mix all of those and just pick and match however you want your preset to sound from these different channels. And don't be afraid to touch them. Every channel has a secret there, or every channel offers something that really changes the overall sound of the piano and can really benefit your mix. Let's go back to the play view and just say, so we had concert. Let's just go through this quickly. With quite a big hall, the intimate sound. Player sound. Let me just catch my mouse here back again. Player sound gives you what you get when you sit in front of the piano. The deep notes to the left. The high notes to the right. And now you can play the jazz tune that I played before. So with the player room mix preset, you have the room mix channel, the first close microphone, and the first mid microphone that come with the standard library. It looks and sounds like this. If I want to exchange my close microphone with the second one that comes with the full library, let's just do this quick and activate the second room channel, bring up the second microphone for the player preset just to see you, to tell you the difference between those microphone characteristics now with a ribbon mic. If you want to get rid of the reverb that you hear, let's switch off the additional reverb. And of course, you're not stuck with the algorithmic reverb that we provide, but you can also use yours. And maybe also switch off the room mix here. So you have a lot of options there. Wherever you want to go, it's a simple click away in the mix page. All right, so you have a pop preset here as well. If you think that's too much reverb for your recording, switch off the room mix, switch off the reverb, and you have a very dry, very direct piano. You can play around with these settings. You can also see that the EQ is already activated here. It is an aggressive piano. It helps you to cut through. And you can always customize the settings any way you like. Ambience is the next preset. A lot of room in there. And the Mighty preset that gives you a lot of, that basically has a slapback. If you play forte, you'll hear it. That's also a good point to explain the runtime that you add to each microphone. So we have 150 milliseconds delay on the room mix channel and 60 milliseconds on the mid microphones. Let's switch both of them off. And now you get a really flat response. Although the reverberated sound is still in there. So these are the factors that you want to consider. Especially with the runtime, you get a lot of additional depth to your sound. Your close microphones, of course, you want to be close and direct as possible. These are the options: EQ, runtime delay. You can add or subtract the reverb here, reverb send. And of course, you have a panning for all the different microphones. The piano was recorded to the right of the conductor's page, and it always depends on the view that you have. So in this case, we're looking at a conductor's view, which means that the two microphones, the two close microphones, are inverted because you're looking at them from the view of the conductor. If you turn it around and you're going for a player position instruments like the player preset, you will see that the two close microphones are not inverted, but the room mix microphone and the mid microphone are inverted because you are listening to the room microphones from the player position. And that's always, when you study those presets a little bit, it's a system that is the same for all the presets. It always depends on which perspective you have. If you're sitting in front of the piano, you're receiving the sound of the room microphones in a different way, which means inverting the panorama. You can always double click and check out the panorama. You don't only have a panorama, but you can also change the balance here. So in case you want to go in and say you want to have a centered piano, you want to have the piano to the right, to the left side instead of to the right, just go in, and there's also a preset for this that shows it. You have a concert centered room mix, and you'll see, okay, so this time what we did is make the close microphone, the panorama, a little bit smaller, but also position it in the middle of the room. And the trick also was that you go with the room mix and you can turn it a little bit to the left. Don't collapse the stereo image, but rather move the whole room with the balance control a little bit to the left as far as you want to, and the whole room impression comes with you. So you can always go in and change the perception of the microphones like you would do in any mixing situation. Okay, so there are three different mixes. The room mix presets are designed to give you a great sound with all the available microphones in the standard library. And with the standard library, you also have the option, if you want to have a more classic sound, the Decatree mixes are just, let me just change that to the, this is the concert room mix that we listen to right now. Now let's switch and load the concert Decatree mix. Now there is no room mix involved, but the Decatree takes care of the room information. Let's double click this one. So now the main and main center microphones. Take care of that sound. It's a closed microphone, the mid microphone with the Decatree with a little bit of a runtime delay that you can adjust, and you can always see as we're listening to a concert preset, the player, the closed microphone is inverted and pushed to the right. If you want to have it a little bit more centered, just do that right here for the close and the mid microphones, and you'll see that the whole positioning changes. So don't be afraid to touch the mixer. Really nothing you can do wrong. You can also check and just say, if it's a little bit too far to the right still, I'm going to go into the main microphone of the Decatree and just move this a little bit to the left, and this whole the whole room impression will come and change with that. So now you have the room mix presets. You like them a lot, especially for recording. If you want to go and finalize your mix, check out the concert, the Decatree mixes. If you have the full library, you have all these additional room microphones. Let's go into the concert surround to stereo mix. We're always trying to use as many microphones as necessary and as little as possible, just to keep, also to keep the CPU load a little bit on the sensible side. The more microphones, the more CPU usage you will get. Of course, but you have a lot of sources to sculpt your sound. So the concert surround to stereo mix now makes use of the first close and second close microphones, of the second mid microphone, the Decatree, and depends a lot on the high surround microphones here to the right. You get a very nice deep sound. If you want to increase that, we can switch. You can really work around with these delays and just switch them on and off and just see what that does. Like this. Right, switch them back on again. Here we go. So you can just use these options. If you don't want to check out the, if you don't want to use the high surround, go for the high stereo and check out what the best sound is for you there. So lots of options. Don't be afraid to touch them. They're always there. If you feel like, let's go to a different setup. It's just a little different preset, and we'll go to the player preset here because everybody's used to that sound. That's the player surround to stereo mix again. As I said before, the inverted panoramas, interesting to see what you can do and how you can make the stereo panorama wider or smaller, always depending on where you want to go. And that's just three microphones for the player, and we decided to go with a high stereo here. Whenever you see that, you know, the high surround would also be ready. It's already prepared for you. It already has the right runtime. Switch it on and maybe bring it in and see what it does for you. Or turn it down, always depending on where you want to go. Oh, I haven't switched it on. So you always see which channel needs to be switched on down here. If you switch it off, there will be no notes triggered. The same is true if you want to solo a track. All the other channels are not receiving MIDI and therefore not straining the CPU. Bring in the high surround. Of course, I have a delay on this. So I have a latency because I have the runtime delay here of 42 milliseconds that really changes the sound. What you might want to do when you record is, especially if you're already on your CPU limit, check out, maybe record just with the closed microphones. And then bring in the additional room microphones later on. So the same for the, if you mute the channel, no MIDI is coming through and no samples are streamed. You always see how many voices you're playing down here, and you also see the RAM usage you have is 238,000 samples in the background when you're loading all the channels. So you get to a high sample count pretty quickly, always depending on what you play. You can have that here. If you overdo it, if you're running into streaming troubles, this meter will light up a little bit and inform you that you're really stressing your computer. You might want to go for a higher latency setting and just see how you can cope better with the settings in here. I actually wanted to show the edit window. What you do in here is you can adjust the volume and the dynamic range, not just globally, like with these global dynamic range settings. That's the same one that you find on the play view. That's the same dynamic range slider you have here. And the global MIDI sensitivity is the same that you have on the play view. You have a maximum voices per microphone setting of 128 and the maximum voices per key setting of 4, which we believe will take you very far. You'll be very happy with those settings. If you have repetitions, there's algorithms in the background that decide for you musically which notes you want to be played and want to have played. Of course, you can play around with the settings. Oh, it all really also depends on how you play and what you play, but this will cover most of it. And you have note volume and note dynamic ranges. So if you click on one or more of those notes and just select a range, you say, you know, that I want the deepest notes to be really loud until I get to the C2 here. And I can now raise, you can decide if you want to see the volume or the dynamic range of the notes. I can now raise the volume of these notes. Mm-hmm. I want to, and just fine tune the piano. If you think that one note is maybe a little bit too low in volume, just go in and adjust it here just a tiny bit. You can see the note volume down here. You can do it here, or you can do it directly in the area down there. You can change the dynamic range of each note. Just go check another setting here and say, I want this note to be a little louder in volume, but I also want it to respond to the MIDI dynamics a little differently. I want it to be more sensitive to the piano, and you can have that note just adjusted correspondingly. So you can really fine-tune the piano. You can select multiple keys, and you can do whatever you like. You can also use a per note EQ. You can apply that to one note or to a section like this one. Just click to activate, and then play around with the settings in the EQ and really find what's the best sound for you with the synchron pianos. So a lot of options there. Double clicking resets it, or control command clicking always resets the controls. So back to PlayView. Of course, you can automate everything. If I want the dynamic range global setting to be learned, I can do that and just move any slider here and just assign that. And every control is assignable also in the mix view. Let's talk about the pedals real quick. Of course, you have a soft pedal. If you right-click a pedal, if you don't have a soft pedal, actually, you can right-click the pedal, which will activate it. Sounds like this. Activating it again. So you hear the soft sound. You have a sostenuto pedal. If you don't have a pedal, this is, I think it's CC67. Right-click it after you play the note. And of course, you can still use the sustain additionally. So it is a sostenuto pedal. Sustain pedal. Of course, there's not only sustain, you can re-pedal sounds, so you can actually catch the sound when you play. So if I play a note and let it go and re-pedal, I'll catch the note dynamically where it was. Again. And I can also re-pedal that sound again. And you always get the right note, but also the right release sample, because the engine in the background is clever enough to do that. You also have half pedaling, which is switched off by default, but you can activate it here in the settings, in the interface. Click activate continuous sustain pedal. What this does is it basically, a sustain pedal is more or less on and off, right? Like this. But of course, you can do half pedaling on a real piano where the damper basically just lifted, not far, not all the way from the strings. And I'm showing you here with a little controller. So I'm showing this, you see this little circle that is closing up on the sustain pedal. And you can just add a little bit of pedaling in there. Until you reach a sustain level where it actually sustains like this. You always see when the circle closes and is totally yellow, then you get the sustained sound. You can also use that to really slowly dampen the sound. And you can check which volume this half pedaling effect should have, just like you can assign the pedal noise that you want to hear. If you have a higher pedal noise, if you're using half pedaling, you might want to increase the pedal noise to 3 or 4 dB, because of course, if you're working with the pedal very intuitively and sensitively, you might have, you want to have that effect worked out a little bit, but that's all a setting that you can assign and you can choose and pick and mix. So all in all, that's the overview of Synchron Pianos. Let me think if I forgot something. Play view, mix view, edit view, the integrated, oh, and on the mix page, if you want to go and send your different channels out to different outputs, of course you can do that. Also, of course, as this is recorded for immersive sounds formats and also for surround, you have those three options in here, room mix, Decatree mix, and surround to stereo down mix presets. If you insert the Synchron Pianos as surround plugins, you have this, those same preset characteristics for a surround setup. Let me just show you quick. So this is the same setup, but now the panoramas, of course, the panorama, the power pans are looking different. They have five dots, as I've inserted it as a 5.1 instrument. And you see how it is panned in here. You see which speakers are already activated in the different presets. And so you have also in the preset browser, you have the surround presets here. So the player surround would be like this. Ambient surround would look like this. Everything already pre-configured and mixed for you. All you have to do is send the outputs to the right outputs on your sound card and you're ready to go for the surround sound. So that's the overview, Synchron Pianos with very powerful features in there. I hope we get a lot of input from you and we can actually provide more presets here. So contact us at support@vsls.co.at, also with any questions that you have, and we'll be happy to improve this. The Synchron Pianos, Yamaha CFX. We're super happy. We want to hear your opinion as well, and we hope you enjoy your new instrument.